this video, we will program a Python AI to play this snake game. I will provide an intuitive explanation of the algorithm, but I won't dive deep into the code, so the goal is to make this video entertaining and informative, but it's not a tutorial. So I used Pygame in Python to make this classic snake game. The goal is to have the snake eat as many apples as possible while avoiding crashing into the walls or its own body. The more apples are consumed, the longer the snake gets, and the more difficult the game becomes. So here's what happens when the snake crashes into its own body. The game just ends. This was me playing it manually, but how do we write a bot to play the game by itself? In any position or state of the game, the snake has four actions, which are the four directions where it can move. The goal is to have each action and each state be associated with a value that represents the expected reward of that action. Basically, it's a measure of how good that action is. So maybe in this case on the screen, going away from the apple gives an average reward of just 0.2. Going up or down is 0.5, and going towards the apple is 0.9, the highest. In this case, the agent simply chooses the action with the highest expected reward. This notion of expected reward is called a Q value. The problem is we don't know these values. The goal of the agent is to learn these values as it plays the game more and more times. These Q values might start at 0, but as the agent explores the environment and gets more experience, these values will become more and more precise for each state and action. I keep mentioning these states. A state is essentially what the snake sees at any point of the game. One idea is to let the snake see everything that's within some distance from its head. Unfortunately, this results in many inputs, which would make learning very slow on my laptop GPU. Instead, I'll represent each state with 12 binary features. The first four are Boolean values about the direction of the snake. The next four deal with the direction of the food, and the last four let the snake know whether there is danger immediately in that direction, which can be a wall or just its own body. All these features are either false, so 0, or true, so 1. These features will give our snake agent enough information to do some serious learning. Also, the agent needs to know what is a good outcome and what is a bad outcome in this game. This is pretty simple. Every apple eaten will be a reward of positive 1, and death will be a reward of negative 10. If none of these things happen at a given step in the game, the reward is simply 0. This diagram shows how the agent interacts with the environment. At any state, the agent takes an action, which takes it into the next state, and carries with it some reward. This is the main equation that powers our algorithm. What we're doing is called Q learning, because we're having the agent learn the Q values of every state and action. Let's take a moment to understand this equation. Every state action pair in the game has a Q value, which could all be initialized to 0 at the beginning. Whenever we are in a specific state and we take a certain action, we will update the Q value based on what happened. This equation, called the Bellman equation, shows us how to make that update. To get the new Q value, we take the original Q value and add a weight times the reward, plus a discount times the best Q value of the next state, minus the original Q value. Think of it this way. If the reward term is high, the new Q value will become higher, because it means this state and action are pretty good. If the best Q value of the next state is high, it means that taking this action brings us closer to a very favorable state, so the Q value of the current state and action will also increase. Through this Bellman equation and enough games, the agent can learn which Q values correspond to every state and action, which will allow it to make better decisions. I will link an article that goes more in depth into Q learning in the video description. The agent starts out by exploring the environment, which means making a lot of random moves to maximize exploration. With more experience, the agent will rely more on its understanding of the environment instead of just random moves. The more
knowledge
the agent acquires, the more it exploits and the less it explores. Now we must decide whether we will use vanilla Q learning or deep Q learning. Vanilla Q learning stores the Q values in a table, while deep Q learning uses a neural network and outputs the Q value for every action. Vanilla Q learning is faster, but deep Q learning is preferred when we have many states and actions and continuous inputs. In our case, we have 12 states that have 2 unique values each for 4096 unique states. There are 4 actions, which are the directions, for a total of about 16,000 state action pairs. This is actually not too high. Our states are also discrete, so I will just use vanilla Q learning, which should learn pretty quickly. This is the code that I came up with for the algorithm. You're welcome to inspect it more closely on your own, but at the bottom you can see the Bellman equation that powers the whole learning process. And then, the agent started learning. After 10 episodes, or games, the snake would just move in one direction, not knowing how to avoid obstacles or get food. But by 100 episodes, the snake ended up consuming one apple before crashing into a wall. There's still a lot of room for improvement. At 200 episodes, the snake intentionally went for apples, which is a sign that it is learning. Unfortunately, it has yet to master wall avoidance. At 400 episodes, there was a breakthrough. The snake is very efficient at getting food, reaching a score of over 40. Unfortunately, it still struggles with avoiding its own body, but it already performed very well. Still, we can do better. If you're still watching the video at this point, I would appreciate it if you subscribe to TechTribe for more videos like this one. Lastly, at 7,500 episodes, or about 10 minutes into training, the snake learning plateaued. Let's see how good it is. It shows very similar performance to the 400 episode snake, except it doesn't die before 50 and goes well beyond that. Can we hit 100? Wow, apparently not, but we were very, very close. Let's run it again, because I won't be satisfied until I see triple digits. Let's play a game. Can you guess whether the snake survives this tricky spot? Yep. What about now? Wow, somehow also yes. And here? Hell yeah, it's unstoppable. And it's dead. Well, with a final score of 122, we did indeed hit triple digits. In a future video, I might increase the number of states to give the snake more information and use deep Q learning to see whether we can beat 122. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to TechTribe.